6. Jason Deb, the Morning X. Another Jason Deb t-shirt prize package could be yours inside half an hour or so. The reviews for Candid Cameo, off the charts. Serena G says, I can't see Nick's face, but I can tell he is not feeling this game. Broken Toilet says, I didn't mind the victory music. The game was fine. Romero in ATX says, damn, Jason, you're definitely not allowed to officiate anymore. I don't think I've ever heard you not give an F as much as I have right now. What are you talking about, man? How dare you? I've given way less Fs before. And Trustin says, my honest opinion of the Cameo game is it's too similar to your other games to be interesting. Well, aren't you just full of constructive criticism today, Trustin? You just got a handful of notes for working today. Thanks for that, man. No Deb today. Nick doing Deb things, sort of. I don't know where he is. Katie is here for a moment. And let's also welcome to the program our man, Dave B. Good day, Dave.
What's up?
What are you doing here? What do you want?
I want to talk about Ozark Season 3.
Yes, Dave is here. Because we're doing our Season 3 Ozark podcast post-show today. Dave assigned us homework. Did you do your Ozark homework, Katie?
Wait, what was the homework?
I literally stayed up past midnight last night just so I could get my top 10.
Why is Katie got to be fired again? And here you see. No, Dave is here for one reason.
Twister came and stole my double wide. Things ain't been quite the same since my hound dog died. Oh, God, I'm so alone. Please, Debo, keep say love me on the phone.
Dave B. already Deb style talking through the intro music. Okay, good job. Excellent work, my friend.
Oh, did they hear that?
Look, okay. Sorry.
I didn't hear it. I have my headphones on.
I'm going to calm down. I don't know if you've been listening, Dave. It's been a day for me. It's been somewhat of a day. I'm fine, okay? I'm doing fine. Serenity now. I know you're not a radio professional. I know that this is a fun thing for you, and it's fun for me, and I appreciate it. I truly am appreciative of anybody who, you know, my friends like to pitch in and have fun, and let's put on a show for the people. Mm-hmm. But when you say something into the microphone, how can you then later say, did they hear that? How do you think this works? You're talking to the microphone. It is then amplified to the city of Austin and on the internet around the world.
I thought sometimes we talk in this and they don't hear us.
When he turns it off. But did you see him touch the board?
If the song is playing and I put my headphones down and I walk out of the studio, that part is not broadcast. You are correct about that. But if
here's the Dave B rule. The mics are always on. Just for you, the mics are always on. Every time you talk into there, pretend that people can hear you.
Yeah.
Well, by the way, I kind of think it's your fault because I was away from the microphone and I said, hey, I texted you the number and you gave me no response. So I was like, oh, maybe I need to talk into his ears.
It's my fault. You can't tell me things on the air while the show is going. Okay? The show is on. There's no, I'm going to tell you something off the air while the show is going. All right?
Okay.
You know what, Dave B?
It doesn't seem like this is something. I know it's.
You know what? You're fired. See, I just wanted to do it before I get the chop.
So, because Deb is not here, we've been scrambling through different I love you call strategies. By the way, Deb wrote a nice message for you guys at 101x.com. If you're watching the video version of this, it's probably just above or below where you're at. So just go check that out. But yesterday, Katie made a noble I love you call attempt. Mm-hmm. And Dave B. came in armchair quarterback in the situation. Something about, this was pretty good, but this is what you need to tweak. And
it was specifically that we needed to send in the closer.
I need a closer.
Oh, okay, so, right, because you set him up good. But
we
didn't
gave Dave B. the tap.
Ah, okay.
Here he comes to close.
I thought that you were inviting him in because Nick was like, feel free to come in, Dave. Do your own I love you call.
You don't got to tell me twice.
I thought it's because you don't know how to take constructive criticism. Unlike myself, I'm great with constructive criticism. I'm absolutely feeling it. So, yeah, Dave is going to call a random business stranger. Not random. He selected it. He texted me the number, in case you guys didn't know.
Did you guys hear that?
Yeah, and then he's going to try and get him to say, I love you. Now, should I out you?
No.
Don't out, just let it happen?
Yep.
Okay. Here we go. Dave B., I love you call.
I did not call them to make sure the number worked. This is what was on the internet.
Oh, okay. Good, good. I'm going to do something unethical, though. All right? Brace yourself.
Whoa, you got butt slammed.
Sorry, Dave. Anytime you hear that, that means we got to play a quick round.
Oh, my God. You know I've been pumping myself up for this call and this character. I was so ready to go.
I don't control the timing.
It's ruined. I lost my moment. I should go full Christian Bale on you right now. Are you a professional? No.
Stop trashing his lights.
For you.
What we should have done is we should have called a number that when it answered, it just played the Jimmy Eat World clip.
Look, guys, I don't control when it happens, all right? But anytime you hear sweetness from Jimmy Eat World, we play a quick round of Jason Eat World, where I try to identify the thing. It's been going great. I've still only gotten 4 correct, and I don't even know what number we're on now, Nick.
I think it's 17 is what I'm going to do
17.
Here.
Yeah. Okay, I got 4 out of the first 8, and now I have gotten... would this be 10 in a row that I haven't gotten? Okay, what's...
Their apostrophe S. It's technically 2 words.
Hang on. Which there?
T-H-E-R-E.
Okay.
There.
There's. There. Dave, have you been following along with this game? Do you like the Jimmy Eat World game?
Can I be honest?
Yeah, I expect nothing less.
I give it about 15 seconds, and then you normally go off the rails, and I'm like, I'll come back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Where do you go when you're like, I'll come back from there?
It depends. If there's a Rosillo pod, I go there. And if there's not, then I just turn it off and focus on something else.
Put your iPod on shuffle and go for a run around the block.
Yep. Hope that first song's
random
not too
generator, number
jammy.
Generator, bitch. Okay, there's, give me the second word.
No.
There's no. Give me the third word.
One.
Dylan, cut to Dave. What? Do that again. Just what was that?
Yeah. I'm still trying to keep warm. I told you I was ready to go.
Loose.
You don't loosen up in the bullpen and they put you on the mound to sit for 10 minutes.
This is true. They never treat a closer this way. This never happens. Okay, give me the third word, Nick.
One.
There's no one. Yeah, I don't. I feel like this is one that I might know, but I don't. I'm going to say Invented by Jimmy Eat World. There's no one in town. Hear you me?
Hear you me.
Hear you me.
This one is also one that I really like.
It's
what? This is also one that I really enjoy.
That's a very good one.
This one isn't very fun.
That's a song about some super fans who died in a car accident on the way to... Something like that. Mm-hmm. Jimmy World once slept on their floor or something. Okay, sorry for that. Dave, there's just nothing. nothing we can do about that. You never know when it's going to play. All right, here we go. Dave.
At least I got a built-in excuse now.
The number you have dialed is not in service.
Instant karma. Instant karma.
I have to dial it off
the
my phone.
The figures you have used to dial are too fat. To obtain a special dialing wand, please mash the keypad with your palm now.
All right, for real this time. I know the first part by heart. Not of Jimmy Eat World songs, of this number. All right, everybody lay out and be cool. Dave is gonna work on some things, okay?
Thank you for calling The Bun. How can I help you?
Hi, my name's Mason, and I just moved to town. I noticed your establishment yesterday when I was driving home. I just had some questions due to this COVID-19. I know that things have changed a little bit. Do I have to wear... Well, can I go in, first of all?
Yes, sir, you can.
Okay. Okay, so I don't have to order online.
No, you do not.
Do I have to wear a mask?
That's optional, sir.
Okay, and do y'all do cold drinks? Because I got a bit of a sissy tongue, so I like
cold
coffee, but I don't like the warm temperature. So I like a frappuccino or an iced coffee, something like that?
Yeah, we do offer those, yes, sir.
Oh, okay, cool. And do y'all do any like homemade pastries or anything like that?
We only have muffins available, and that's our only option.
Okay, cool. We can sit there and drink there, or do we got to take it to go?
You can sit here and drink here, sir. Yes, and we wipe down and sanitize everything.
Okay. You say your name is Haley?
Emmy.
Emmy.
Almost.
Well, yes. Thank you so much, Emmy. You've just been a blessing. Love you.
We look forward to seeing you.
Love you.
All right, love you too. Bye.
Bye.
What? Oh, my God. Don't say
elbow. Oh my God. What is...
That's a power.
All right, okay. Hang on. Let me see that number. That is the number from Mrs. Dave B. She is sitting in the kitchen. They were working on this accent together.
I gotta say, my bad at the beginning. I didn't say, who are we calling? What was that?
The Blend, a coffee shop.
Okay, where was
it? The Blend. It was in Florida, Newberry, Florida.
Yeah, okay.
I had everything laid out, bro. Yeah. I'm Mason, my brother's Jason, and we got our big brother, he Grayson. We're probably going to go up there, hang out for a little bit. We just moved down from Dasher, Georgia.
All right.
You know, I got a new job over in Gainesville at the university.
Sorry about your sissy tongue. That's
that's good, right?
Yeah.
Just put my camera, Dave.
Nick's camera is
down now.
Look what you did.
I'm pumped. I can't help it. This is good. I don't even want to do the Ozark pod anymore. I might just walk out George Costanza style.
That was pretty... That's pretty incredible, Dave. I gotta say, I don't know. Has anybody ever gone one for one? Has anybody ever?
I'm not one for one.
No. Oh, you've done it before?
I've done one before. I'm 500.
Dave, you should have lied right there and said yes.
Nah, it's not my style. Bro.
Now, is it acceptable that Dave was able to prep and write a full backstory?
Well,
because
first,
we could. I'm gonna say yes because Deb could do that every day if she wanted.
Yeah, yeah,
all right?
Yeah.
It literally takes 5 minutes of prep. Uh-huh. If you can just tell the person where they're at.
That's a good point. Like, sometimes I've already told
them. We just moved down. I'm down the road by the middle school. So, we were close.
I mean, how long does it take to read some Smarter Than Trivia? That doesn't happen. My one concern is that I don't know if what you did was like appropriate in 2020. That might have been like when you do voices and accents.
But
accents.
I'm from
that
Georgia. I'm that country. I think Florida man.
What color are you?
I'm white. I'm a redneck.
Oh, so you're doing white voice? Inappropriate.
I mean, I'm 50-50, even though...
I didn't even feel good saying, what color are you? Are you allowed to say that anymore? That didn't feel good.
I shouldn't have brought it up.
Dave, thumbs up. That was well played, my man.
Thanks, buddy.